Well, the title of the presentation is Automatic Indexing of Institutional Repository Content using SCoS. And we want to present and to discuss one experiment, one activity that we are developing with the university where I am working, Universidad Carlos III in Madrid. And this activity is related to one problem that I think is extended in all the or in most of the institutional repositories that we're using to publish the contributions of the members and the staff working in the universities. The problem is that the lack of well-defined indexing practices, we think it's a general issue that we need to deal with, and we need to provide some kind of solution. Typically, the researchers, the authors of the documents, are the people who are in charge of assigning a set of keywords to the submissions, to the documents that they publish in the repositories. And the problem is that in most of the cases, these terms, these keywords, are not taken from controlled vocabularies or thesauris or equivalent tools. And as we can think, the use of natural language without any kind of control translates into ambiguity and lack of specific indexing terms.
Excuse me, Dr. Oetterbrunn, yes? May you just turn off your webcam while you're presenting so the slides are more visible?
Okay.
Thank Perfect. You.
Okay, yes, now it's much better, I think. Okay, so this is the problem, and what might be like something like a local problem, okay, a problem that we think, okay, this happens only in your, in a particular repository. The problem becomes worse when we are thinking and we are dealing with tools that aggregate content coming from multiple repositories. So for example, I think that this is something that is used quite often. There are different tools at the regional, at the national level, that are taking contributions and items from different repositories, and they are doing an aggregation of the content. And then, if people are assigning keywords without any kind of control, the problem becomes greater when we take content coming from multiple sources. So the approach that we are checking is to complete the automatic assignment of descriptors taken from an existing thesaurus or knowledge organization system, and to assign these terms to contributions already published in the repositories. To do this exercise, we have used a commercial tool that is called Pool Party, and I am sure that most of you have already heard about this tool. I think it's developed by a company in Austria, and the results, at least for the experiments that we have completed, are very positive. Well, of course, there are other tools. We are not linked to this company or to this tool, but the results are very positive. And well, the idea is, and what you can do with this tool is to run a process that automatically identifies the concepts or the terms that are used in the documents, and the tool is making some kind of matching between the terms that appear in the metadata of the items from the repository and the concepts that appear in the thesaurus, considering that for when we talk about a concept in the thesaurus, this concept might be linked to different linguistic representations or terms having an equivalent or a similar meaning. We go ahead. We made some previous work on this topic of automatic indexing in the context of collaborative open innovation platforms. This is just to introduce this previous activity. when we talk about innovation, innovation is a knowledge-intensive process, and typically, for example, if you refer to the Oslo Manual, that is like the main reference discussing innovation as a process, they talk about linkage, two main services that connect innovative organizations with other entities in the context. And these entities might be universities, might be suppliers, might be users, might be competitors. And the idea is that to develop some kind of innovation, there is like a flow of knowledge between all these entities or partners. So the idea, when we talk about open innovation platforms, this can be seen as websites that work in a similar way as a directory of entities, people, companies, etc., that can be involved in the development of any kind of innovation. The point is that to be effective, these platforms must manage and must keep data about researchers, lead users, university departments, research groups, etc., and to have an accurate representation of the capabilities of these partners or these potential partners, it's important to know what is their work experience and the technical achievements that they have complete. These technical achievements might be patents, papers, product worksheets, etc. Something that can demonstrate that these entities have experience and have working knowledge on a specific area. And also in these platforms, people keep information about the innovation opportunities or challenges. We can say that in a typical use case, there is one company who publishes one challenge, something, one problem that they want to solve, and then other people involved in the website, in the open innovation platform, they can suggest solutions. Then the people posting the challenge, they will evaluate the solutions and they will decide who is the winner of the challenge, okay? Who can be the best partner to develop or to complete the solution to the innovation problem that has been posted. In this context, we make a study about the possibility of improving the matching capabilities between the challenge and the entities answering to them. And in this case, we identify that the potential use of terminologies or controlled vocabularies could be very useful to have a description of entities, challenges, areas of expertise, etc., using a common language. At this point, let's to develop one analysis in the area of biomedical engineering. It's an interesting area because there are different disciplines and topics that are merged or are that part of this branch of engineering. And we made a development with one tool that is provided by the medical subject headings that is called MES on Demand. MES on Demand is like a web service. You can pass to this web service a free text description, one document describing something, and this tool is going to give you the terms defined in the medical subject headings that represent the content that is behind this that document. So we use the MES on Demand service to complete the automatic indexing of entities, that's to say companies, researchers, research groups, etc. Typically, these entities are represented by a description and documents that describe the things that they are doing. For example, in the case of the researchers, you can use as an input the CV of the researchers, the papers that he has written. And in the case of the companies, you can use, for example, as an input, the description of the products that the company is developing. So this is the input to be sent to the MES on Demand. And in the case of the indexing, for example, of the innovation opportunities, is the same. You have the description of a challenge, something, a problem description, And this textual description can be matched against the medical subject headings to identify what are the main topics being discussed. Just to show one example, I think that here we have some results of this exercise. This is a CV, for example, of a professor in biomedical engineering. And when we send this textual description of the CV to Meds on Demand, we get as a result a set of terms coming from the medical subject heading that represent the expertise of this specific researcher. These terms are coming from a controlled vocabulary. We can do the same exercise, for example, with a company. So we take the typical white paper writing by a company describing a set of services, and we send this document to Meds on Demand, we can get also a set of terms that describe the expertise of this company in the area of biomedical engineering. And we can do the same, for example, with a challenge, okay, an innovation opportunity, a problem. Here some people is searching for a solution to a specific problem that is described here. This is coming from an innovation, an open innovation platform that is called Innocentive. And if we take this textual description and we pass it to Meds on Demand, we get also the list of keywords, the list of terms that represent the content or the main topics in this challenge. Okay. Once we have these information pieces indexed using the same a common language, the medical subject headings, of course, it's possible to improve the matching between the problems, the people, the companies, etc., and to think on different improvements and different ways to try to match the problem descriptions with the agents who can contribute to the solution of these problems. What happens in the case of the institutional repositories? We think that there is a similar situation and a similar problem. At the end, people are using self-archiving policies, okay, to post contributions and to attach keywords in natural language, in free text, to these contributions. In most of the cases, there is no terminology or vocabulary control at all. And only in some cases, we have identified that people in the libraries, they assign to the items in the repository general high-level categories. Of course, we are missing the benefits of working with controlled vocabularies. Okay, for example, there is no way of leading the users to relevant content. Okay, we have to rely on natural language in free text searching without any kind of control. And we are missing also the opportunity of giving users the capability of browsing the repository from a conceptual perspective. In fact, most of the repositories, what you can do as a user is to browse through a series of communities and collections that are based on the organization of the universities in different faculties, departments, etc. But this is not based on the conceptual on the concepts and on the knowledge schema that is behind the documentation. So this is a problem, especially when we are thinking on the integration of items coming from different repositories. It's true that we have achieved a high level of syntactic interoperability between the repositories using protocols like Open Access Initiative, the protocol for metadata harvesting, or similar protocols. But when we think on semantic interoperability, we have not reached a similar point. Okay, so for example, if we go to, I mentioned before, the aggregator sites. For example, in Spain, we have Recolecta, that is a website that is aggregating data from multiple repositories, but they are not yet applying any kind of vocabulary control or on the items. So at the end, we are just aggregating keywords provided by the user, and this is not enough to ensure the accurate indexing and retrieval of the information. In fact, if we go to an aggregator site, the typical organization that we have based on communities and collections, based on the departments and faculties that we have in the universities, it doesn't make any sense. Because of course, this is something that is different depending on the university, and for the end user, this kind of organization is not providing any value. So this is I think that this is the place where it's more possible to see the kind of problem that you are describing. And to solve this problem, we analyzed the possibility of using the automatic assignment of terms coming from a thesaurus. The experiment was conducted with metadata and items published in the repository of our university that is called eArchivo. The idea was to assign descriptors coming from a recognized, widely used thesaurus, and we decided to use the UNESCO thesaurus. And with the help of one tool that is called PoolParty, that is the tool that is doing this kind of term extraction, and also doing the matching between the terms extracted from the documents and the terms in the thesaurus, and the experiment was completed with a subset of 6,000 records. Well, here this is a description of the institutional repository of the university. Just to mention that it was created several years ago in 2006 in the context of a larger initiative to create an open archive network of the public universities in Madrid. And typical objectives are the integrate and preserve the intellectual production of the university, increment the visibility and the impact of the scientific output of the university, give free access to the content. It is based on the DSpace tool. And regarding the submission policy, is based on voluntary self-archiving submission from the authors, and they are in charge of providing the keywords. Okay, as we said before, is the typical case in most of the universities in repositories in Spain.
One moment. Yes. My apologies to interrupt. Just to remind, we have about 1 to 2 minutes remaining, and we already have a question, if I may share it with everyone. The question is, you argued for controlled vocabularies in automatically indexing documents. Wouldn't manual indexing with a controlled vocabulary improve semantic interoperability as well?
Yes, I think so. In fact, the problem is that if we are not using these kind of tools, thesaurus or controlled vocabularies to index the content, and if we rely only on the keywords provided by the authors of the document, at the end it's not possible it's very hard to have the capability of searching and finding relevant content, especially when we are putting together items and documents and metadata coming from different repositories and indexed by different authors. So the use of a thesaurus or controlled vocabularies in general can improve the situation, especially when it's possible to do it automatically. I think that this is the main benefit. Because of course, if the authors have to index the content manually using a thesaurus, it's very complex for them. But if we have the capability of doing this indexing automatically using these kind of tools, we think it's possible to get a significant improvement in the whole process and in the searching capabilities provided by the repositories.
Yeah. Thank you for that answer.